Hey babe, so welcome back to my channel. Getting into the skincare routine, I always make sure I wash my hands before touching my face because we don't want to transfer any germs from our hands to our face. That just defeats the whole purpose of trying to wash our face in the first place. So make sure you're washing your hands for at least 20 seconds. And then I'm going to be going in with my CeraVe Hydrating Facial Cleanser. I really love this cleanser because I have more dry to combination skin. So this just leaves my skin feeling very hydrating, not stripped, not dry. And I just really love the way it feels. I was using the other one, the Foaming Facial Cleanser, for more like oily skin. And I feel like it just left my skin feeling a little bit too dry. So I definitely recommend this one. The only thing about it is it doesn't foam up. So you don't really feel like you're cleaning your face. It's more of like a lotion. But I do massage it in my face for about 30 seconds with warm water. And then as you can see, I just rinse it off. So as you can see here, I'm just putting on some CarMax. Y'all, my biggest pet peeve is having dry lips. Like, I literally hate the feeling of having dry lips. So make sure you're keeping them lips moisturized, especially during the colder months. Now I'm going in with my Teamy Detox Mask. Y'all already know I love this mask. And as you can see, y'all, I really use this mask. Like, I'm almost finished with it. I love this mask. You can use my code ANAYA25 if you want to purchase. Y'all, this mask cleared my dark marks all the way up. I will not lie to y'all, if y'all go back to like my recent videos, probably like back to May or April, you can see like I had like some dark marks and stuff on my forehead and on like my chin and stuff like that. Once I start using this mask, y'all, I will not lie to y'all, I promise you, it really does work. Once again, you can use my code to get money off ANAYA25 at checkout and Teamy Blend. I love it so much. But yeah, that's all I'm doing is applying this face mask just on my cheeks and a little bit on my forehead. I don't really put the mask all over my face anymore. I just feel like it's kind of unnecessary. I'm just putting it in the spots where I feel like I would break out the most or have like my dark marks. So I'm just doing that, and then I'm going to let it sit on my face. And then I came back, and as you can see, y'all, the skin is just so bright. It's giving me so much like brightness and just like moisturized and hydrated. So now I'm going in with my CeraVe Daily Moisturizing Lotion. I love this stuff so much because it is so lightweight. A lot of these moisturizers, they can be very heavy and they just make you sweat, and it's just like it's too much. Like, I love this because it's lightweight. It doesn't feel like I have a moisturizer on. It's hydrating. My skin feels so fresh, and it just really gives me the results that I need. And then I'm just taking a little bit of my what is this stuff called, hydrocortisone 1%, and I don't use this as much anymore. Really, I've been using it recently because I do have eczema, and during the colder months my eczema does like to flare up, and around my mouth I can get like some super like dry patches and stuff like that, and this just helps calm all of that down and smooth my skin back out. It also helps with hyperpigmentation and uneven skin tone. So I do like to just use a little bit of that on top of my daily moisturizing lotion. But I don't use this in the daytime. This is only a part of my like nighttime skincare. That's like the only difference, because if I put this on in the daytime, sometimes it can be too heavy and I will like start to sweat and feel really oily and stuff like that. But I do like to use this at nighttime. But yeah, this is what my skin looks like. Now I'm just going to get into some tips on maintaining your clear skin. Yeah, so I decided to give you guys some tips on how to maintain your skin after you do your skincare routine. A lot of people, they do their skincare routine and they just think automatically that if I do this routine that my skin is going to clear up. There are a lot of things that, you know, there are a lot of things that come into factor when you're trying to maintain clear skin. So I just want to give you guys some quick tips on how to do that along with the skincare routine. I really hope you guys did just enjoy my skincare routine, and a lot of the products that I use, I really love. I find that the less products I use on my skin, the better results I get. I used to use like exfoliators, I used to use all of these different face washes that have just so many harsh ingredients that's just too harsh on my skin. So I advise you guys, when it comes to your skincare routine, try to use as less products as possible. I only use 3 products and that's my whole skincare routine. Now when you get into using 6, 7, 8, 9 up to 10 products for your skincare routine, I know some people like to use serums and oils and 3 face washes and exfoliates and all these masks and all this stuff. That's a lot of ingredients. That's a lot of chemicals. That's just a lot of stuff that you're putting on your skin at one time. And it can just be too much. It can cause irritation. It can cause your skin to have an allergic reaction. You might get a rash, itchiness. It's just too much, okay? So I highly, highly recommend you guys to try to keep your skincare routine to at least like 1 to 4 products maximum. I wouldn't really try to go over that, in my opinion. But for me, I did do a lot of research when I just changed up my skincare routine recently. If you guys don't know who Hyrum is on YouTube, he makes like a lot of different skincare videos, looking at different brands and reading the ingredients. And it's like really, he really educated me on like these brands and like the ingredients and stuff that are in these face washes that we're actually putting on our face. And as most of you know, I did used to use Clean and Clear, but I'm so glad I don't use it anymore. It was drying out my skin. It had a lot of fragrance in it and I couldn't seem to get these little texture bumps that I had on my face away, and it was really hard for me to do that. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, it's not like pimples. I don't know if you guys can like relate to it, but it's not like pimples that I had on my face. It kind of felt, it just was like a texture. It was like just like a textured skin on my face that I just couldn't seem to get away. I tried so many different things and nothing would seem to be working until I started using CeraVe. Now CeraVe, you guys, it has hyaluronic acid in it. If you want to Google hyaluronic acid and see all the benefits and stuff it has for your skin, it's amazing. It's hydrating. It helps clear your skin, but it's not too harsh, so it's great for sensitive skin. And I really, really just love this product. So I really do highly recommend that you guys try using CeraVe. Or another great brand to use is Cetaphil or Cetaphil. The only thing, I did try Cetaphil, but I think I really just like CeraVe much, much better. But Cetaphil is also a really good cleanser for more sensitive skin, and it does work wonders as well. So getting into some of the tips, my first tip is that you guys try to make sure that you're drinking at least 3 bottles of water a day. So I would say at least like one 16-ounce bottle of water, which is like your average bottle of water. Try to drink at least 3 of those. So if you don't buy like cases of water in your home, if you drink tap water or whatever, you can order like a big water bottle off of Amazon, or you can go to Walmart, Target, whatever, to get you a big water bottle and try to like do the math. So 16 times 3 is I think like 48 or something like that. So you want to be making sure you're drinking at least 48 ounces of water a day. Most of the water bottles, they have how many full ounces it can fit in it. So if you can look at it, see how many ounces it fits in there, and then you can kind of, you know, calculate how much water you should actually be drinking a day. Water is really what's gonna help, you know, flush out any toxins we have in our body, which can have a lot to do with why we're breaking out, or if we have like a lot of high sugar levels, or a lot of like extra hormones. If you're on like different birth controls or anything like that, that can play a lot of role into, you know, that can play a big factor into your skin and how it looks and everything like that. Also, if you are on like medication and stuff like that, it can also make your skin break out. So you do want to make sure that you're drinking enough water to just flush everything out. And you know, water is overall very, very good for us. We are made out of 75% water, so you do want to make sure you're drinking enough water each day. My next tip is to make sure that you guys are washing your sheets and your pillowcases weekly. Like every week, maybe like every Sunday or every Saturday. Just pick a day out of the week where you know you're going to have time to wash your sheets. Or if you can't wash them, at least try to change them. Because you don't want to keep sleeping in the same sheets and pillowcases for too long, because, you know, it does build up and absorb a lot of bacteria from just sleeping, drooling, crust, and any products we may have on our face could be rubbing on our sheets and pillows and stuff like that, and then we're rubbing back on it and then it gets dirty, and it's just not really hygienic to keep sleeping on the same sheets and pillowcases because they just start to smell. It's like kind of wearing the same dirty clothes over and over and over again, you know what I'm saying? You don't really want to do that. So make sure you guys are changing your sheets or pillowcases or washing your sheets and pillowcases weekly if you can. So my next tip is just to make sure that you're being consistent with your routine. Don't start the routine, you know, whatever. We also don't start something that you feel like you can't finish, you know what I'm saying? So once you start that routine, if you're going to wash your face day and night, make sure you're consistent with that routine. Every day, wake up, brush your teeth, wash your face, go through your routine, and boom, move on. Don't start skipping days, don't start missing nights, don't start missing days. Once you start, you know, getting your routine all over the place, that's when people start to complain about, oh, this doesn't work for me. Or it's like, what did you be consistent with it? I would say when you get a routine down for you, try it at least, I would say at least once to twice a day for at least 7 days straight. Take a before and an after picture, and if you feel like your skin really isn't improving or it's making your face worse, then I will probably say it doesn't work for you, or you know, you shouldn't use it. But be consistent with your routine. You know, skin is not going to come, clear skin is not going to come overnight. You have to be patient. So don't expect, you know, oh, if I use these products for 2 days, then my skin should just be boom boom bouncing and so clear and smooth. Sometimes it can take up to months for your skin to get to where you want it to be, but you really just have to be patient with it. It's like hair growth. Your hair isn't gonna grow overnight. Don't think you can use a magic oil or a magic conditioner and your hair is just gonna grow 10 inches in 2 days. It doesn't work like that. It's the same thing with your skin. Skincare journeys is a process. That's why it's a journey. But you just want to, you know, stay patient and be consistent with your routine, and in due time you should get the results that you want. My next tip is to try not to wear too much makeup or any products that have a lot of fragrance in it too much on your face every day. I know sometimes we like to put on makeup and we want to pop out and want to be cute and stuff like that, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that, but you do want to give your skin a chance to breathe and air out, and you don't want to be clogging your pores every day with a lot of makeup or things that have a lot of fragrance in it, because makeup products have a lot of fragrance in it. If you actually sit down and read ingredients, some makeup products even have perfume in it, and things that are just like completely unnecessary and really don't need to be going on your face. So you do want to be careful when you're doing things like that. If you do wear makeup, try to take like at least 1 or 2 days out of the week where you just don't wear makeup or rock the natural face, or if you aren't comfortable with not wearing makeup yet because of your skin or whatever the case may be, maybe just try to like wear a little bit less than maybe just try to wear like a little bit less than you usually will wear, or try to use like a BB cream, which is like a foundation or concealer, but it's not as heavy and it's not going to really clog your pores as much. It still gives you like a coverage that you want, but it's not super super harsh, you know what I'm saying? So maybe you can like explore some different products or something like that, but I really will recommend you guys to not wear makeup every day because it can really just dry your skin out. You start to look really flushed and it's not going to be cute. So me personally, especially if you're not really going to be sticking to your skincare routine like that, you're going to be careful with wearing a lot of makeup and stuff every day. So I would say just take at least 1 to 2 days out of the week where you don't wear no makeup, or you do like a lighter load or not as much or something like that. My next tip is to keep your hands and your hair out of your face. So obviously you don't want to be touching your face with your dirty hands all day, especially with COVID going on right now. You know, that's not really something that we want to be doing anyways, but try not to be touching your face too much, all up on your cheeks and your chin and your forehead and scratching your face and rubbing your eyes and stuff like that. One, because you're just transferring germs from your hands to your face, which is just clearly it's gonna cause breakouts, pimples, just gonna be getting dirt on all in your skin and stuff like that, and it's just gonna be sitting in your skin all day And you know, that could all just be prevented if we just don't touch our face in the first place. So try to keep your hands out of your face and also your hair. A lot of people don't realize that a lot of the products and stuff that we put in our hair, if it gets on our face, it can really break us out. A lot of products that have like a lot of oil in it and stuff like that. So like if you use like a lot of hairspray and stuff like that on your hair, try to keep it out of your face, because once that hairspray and stuff starts to rub on your face and the oils and stuff like that can get in your cheeks and your skin, and it can clog your pores and create pimples and bumps and things like that. So be careful on what hair products you're using and how they're styling your hair, and try not to have it so much, you know, in your face to where it can break out your skin. My last tip is to make sure that you are washing your face mask weekly or daily or as needed. If you only have one face mask, I would recommend that you're washing it at least like 3 to 4 times a week. Honestly, like every other day, I would probably be washing my face mask, the reusable ones. One, because you know, we're breathing in it, our breath, and that stink, like hot breath. I'm just thinking about like, that's just kind of nasty, and it gets dirty over time, especially if you're throwing it in your purse a lot, pulling out your pocket, you have it laying out and around, people could be touching it, your hands probably aren't always clean when you're touching your mask. So you do want to make sure that you're washing your mask frequently, because that can have a lot a reason as to why your cheeks and like this lower half could be breaking out. That actually happened to me. My face was breaking out a few weeks ago because of my mask, and I was forgetting to wash it, and I would just be throwing it on, and I had to suffer the consequences. But make sure you guys are washing your face mask, or if you can't wash it weekly, try to use like the one use face mask, like the surgical mask, and just use a new one every day. Or if you're using the reusable ones, I would say try to wash your mask probably every other day to every other 2 days, because you know, we do have to wear a face mask basically everywhere we go now. So you're probably wearing a mask every day unless you're not like leaving the house or something like that. But I would say wash it every 1 to 2 days. So that's pretty much all of my tips for, you know, maintaining your clear skin. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I love you guys so much, and comment down below if you learned something new, if you learned a new tip, or what you learned from this video or anything like that. Or comment down below your skincare routine, maybe you can help somebody else out. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Once again, follow me on all my social media, it is in the description box down below, and my Instagram is on the screen. I love you guys, and I will see y'all in my next video. Peace.